MTV. This is second of 2013 FIBO. Second day, as you can see, is busy. Guys, we're going to bring you lots of more updates on the superstars, more info, more and more everything for you guys. So just make sure you tune in and watch it. Just follow me if you want. I'm with one of the guys, Milov Cerchev. How are you today?
Very good. Thank you for having me on your show.
Thank you. Thank you for giving your time. What do you think about FIBO 2013?
Well, I'm about the 20th time at the FIBO. It's ever expanding. It's bigger every year. And it's the really biggest fitness show in the world. And everybody who is everybody in the fitness is here. So if you're involved, you better be here.
Right. Do you think any difference between 2013 and the previous years?
Well, it's much bigger, as you know. It used to be in Essen, now it's here in Cologne. It's dramatically bigger. There's more companies, there's more to see, more people to meet, more events. So it's growing. I absolutely plan to be here next year as well.
Perfect. Good to see you as well. Tell us about yourself. Obviously, lots of people know about you. Tell us about the police workers, you know, sitting behind the monitor and watching you today. Tell us about yourself and your, you know, supplements and everything.
Yes. Well, as you probably know, I competed 72 times as a professional. Qualified for Olympia 10 times. Back in 92, actually, I had the pleasure to come to Poland and I did a seminar in Warsaw.
That
was very memorable in a theater. I would love to come back there as well. I just established connection with the Perfect Body magazine. I think I'm going to be writing some articles for you guys and expanding, sharing my knowledge with you. I have a new supplement line that you can see here. It's 25 different products. Yeah, it's Milos Cerchev's signature line. It's designed for all the athletes, as you know. I prepare about 50 different Olympia competitors throughout the years. You know, so if you are at the elite level, you need elite training, elite nutrition, and elite supplements.
Correct.
So this is my line.
Right, correct. Have you seen Olemp stand in FIBO today? Have you seen a stand? Have you seen Olemp stand today in FIBO?
Yes, I went there today. It's fantastic. It's really, you know, mind-boggling, really.
It's the biggest one.
It is the biggest one. It's a leading one. I mean, Olympia's huge. You know, it's just, you know, unmeasurable.
And obviously, as an experienced bodybuilder, who was your inspiration in the bodybuilding industry?
Well, when I started, of course, Arnold Schwarzenegger and Frank Zane were my idols, and especially Frank Zane, because I appreciated his type of physique. Arnold is Arnold, you know, he's always going to be a king. But Frank Zane really influenced me, you know, to start what I'm doing. And I kind of became a Frank Zane of the 90s. I had the pleasure of talking to Frank. At one point, he told me that I'm his favorite bodybuilder of the 90s. So that's really huge.
That's lucky
for me, yes.
Yeah, well, you are lucky. Well, tell us about the supplement. You mentioned about the supplements, but tell about, you know, when do you take the supplements and how often do you train? You know, what if somebody out there want to start bodybuilding, okay? Because these days, not everybody could afford supplements. Young kids want to, you know, follow your footprints.
Yes.
And what supplement do you want to tell him, you know, is main important one? And how often do you train as a basic trainer?
Okay, first, when you go to train, you have to maximally stimulate the muscle fiber. It's not really about lifting weights. I said this in Poland, actually. I don't know if you guys were there back in 92. I told everybody to stand up and do the concentration curls with nothing, no dumbbells, nothing in the hands, you know, to start establishing mind-muscle connection and feel the maximal contraction. So really, bodybuilding training is about feeling the muscle. If you train chest, feel the chest, not shoulders or triceps. If you do the biceps, feel exactly, you know, which part of the biceps is working. So when you train, you stimulate. Now, if you are stimulating and not eating, you're going to actually get smaller. So you have to really pay attention to your diet, very high protein, chicken, turkey, fish, beef, eggs, milk. And if you can afford, then you should take some protein supplements, either protein powders or amino acids. Amino acids is the building blocks, would you know, basically build the tissues. So if you ask me what is the most important, absolutely take a protein or amino acids. Carbohydrates, mass gainers, you know, this is a plus, but you can actually have it in a normal food.
Well, that's a lot of knowledge, you know, guys. You should, you know, the lesson to what Marvin just mentioned. As I'm going to ask you about yourself, yes. Are you a family man?
I'm a family man, absolutely.
Right, you got a kid?
Obviously. I have a, you know, 15-year-old daughter, yes.
Right, okay. Isn't that difficult for you? Because, you know, obviously you have to put a lot of time and effort to be here. Isn't that difficult for you?
Well, you know, everything in life is difficult, but difficult doesn't mean impossible. You know, very few people actually have a passion in life. And I do want to say that bodybuilders are one of the most passionate people. You know, discipline that we have, it's really, you know, unmeasurable, you know, by many means. Because if you really want to, you know, pursue this to the elite level, you have to sacrifice. And usually your family understands it. You know, so yes, you know, nothing comes easy. But as I said, difficult is not impossible.
Well, that is correct. Nothing impossible with a lot of training, a lot of motivation. If you have motivation, you know, you could get there and achieve a lot. As a very experienced bodybuilder, if yourself, did you have a coach?
I never had a coach, but I coached many other athletes. You know, basically when I started in Yugoslavia, there was not much information. You know, so I actually had to learn on my own. I was fortunate that my father was Doctor of Science of Neuropsychiatry. So, you know, his
knowledge. He had the knowledge.
Yeah, his knowledge in medicine actually, you know, gave me some insight. It was actually quite different, and I can maybe use this opportunity to say this. My father back 30 years ago told me, when you train, you have perfect opportunity to deliver nutrients in the exact muscle fiber that you're training. So contrary to everybody else, there's basically training on the empty stomach. They create a catabolic event because they deplete glycogen, ATP, you know, amino acids. He told me to supply my body with pre-digested amino acids and glucose, pre-workout, and then when we start training, hyperemia, increased blood flow to the muscle is maximal, and maybe 60% of the blood goes in exact muscle that you're training. So, you know, that carbohydrate is going to trigger insulin release. Insulin is a storage hormone, is going to take amino acid, creating glutamine, and put everything into the cells. So that way you actually become anabolic, you know, and muscle building during the training, not after. So this is the advantage that I had from knowledge of my father, and I actually teach this to many other pros.
Well, you know, what you just said is a lot of knowledge, and if somebody out there listening to what you said, you know, you could just get there. Last couple of questions I want to ask you. I know you're tired, I know you're busy today.
Okay.
Do you recommend the guys want to train on their own or have some training partner?
It's absolutely, training partner is a plus. When I train by myself, it's just normal human nature. You want to quit, you can't push yourself, you know, that hard. So training partner is absolute benefit. So if you don't have one, get somebody that is hungry and that they want to, you know, try to compete with you and then push each other, you know, to the new level.
Well, that is correct, yeah. Just last thing I want to ask you, any motivation you want to give all the Polish warriors sitting down? Any motivation? Because you're a very knowledgeable person, and me talking to you, be honest, I picked up a lot of knowledge and a lot of tips I didn't even know myself, to be honest. So all those guys out there, anything you want to say?
Yes, as my Slavic brothers, I would want to say that the Polish bodybuilders can reach absolute top level. You know, if you actually believe that you can do it, and there is no reason, we are not inferior or superior to anybody else. But if you do everything that you're supposed to, it's human body, human physiology, you maximally stimulate in a training your muscle fibers, and you have a maximum nutrition, you're going to absolutely reach a top level. I competed 10 times at Olympia. I had, a huge record. I managed to beat Jay Cutler and Ronnie Coleman, Dexter Jackson, and, you know, Samir Bernut, many, you know, Mr. Olympias, right? And I am no better than you. So if I could do it, you can do it too.
Well, you heard what he said. If he could do it, you could do it. So, guys, listen, and, you know, make sure you listen, because it's not easy saying that you listen to what this legend said. Thanks ever so much for your time. It's an absolute honor. Thank you.
Thank you. Cheers, guys.